can't stay away from you too long. Even if I do, I'll always call, checking on you, make sure you're okay. Be the one to brighten up your day. Yeah, yeah. And the point of it all is I love you.
Ingrid, I was born and raised in Birmingham, Alabama. I attended the University of Montebello, and I'm currently an English teacher working on my PhD.
I'm Eugene. I'm from Talladega, Bethlehem, Alabama. I attended the University of Alabama in Tuscaloosa, Rhode Island. Currently, I'm working with a consulting engineering firm here in Birmingham.
At my friend's birthday party, he approached and just started talking about his college life. He talked a little bit about being from Talladega and about his church. One of our sorority songs came on, so we went to stroll. And then when after the stroll was over, Eugene found me again and asked for my number. I didn't feel comfortable giving it to him at that time, so I took his later. I didn't really plan on calling him back. You know, who does? You just meet somebody. I didn't really plan on calling him back, but I did. I texted him about a week later, and he asked for my name. And I'm thinking, okay, he talks to a lot of girls. He doesn't even remember my name. We just met last week, but I gave my name anyway, and he said, how could I forget a lovely lady of DST? And that just sparked our communication. We talked all day that day. Now, little did I know, later that night, my sisters were planning a surprise birthday party for me. And my sister heard me talking about him all that day. And she invited Eugene to the surprise party. And that's how we started.
Ingrid and I first met. A friend of mine invited me to go to a birthday party, one of his friends. And I wasn't doing anything that particular night, so I agreed to go. And while there, me and a friend of mine, we kind of just walked around, mingled, met a few people, but you know, there were a group of girls standing, you know, in our view site. He wanted to go over and approach, and you know, I was telling him, you know, we've been standing here too long, and they've already noticed that we're looking at them, so we might not want to go over at this point, because in their minds, we're too shy now, because they noticed us noticing them a long time ago. But he convinced me to go ahead over and talk to them. And, when we walked up, you know, I began to notice that there were a lot of ladies in this room, and you know, some less classily dressed than others. And I noticed that this particular young lady was cute in attire, but yet and still she was classy in attire, and that really caught my attention. So we approached her, and I told her who I was and whatnot. And, you know, I was going to ask for a number, but I didn't. And then a particular song came on, so she had to leave. But when she came back, I asked her for a number, but to my surprise, she decided not to give it to me, which was a surprise to me. But yet and still, it made me respect her a little bit more in contact. But a week or so later, I was coaching a little league basketball game. And during the game, I received a text message. When I checked the text message, it was from a young lady whose number wasn't in my phone. I asked who it was, and she told me. And from then on, I knew who she was, and we talked all that day. Later on that night, I got a text from another number that wasn't stored in my phone. Now I'm thinking maybe somebody else is texting me from that night, but it was her sister texting me to invite me to a birthday party that they were throwing for her that was a surprise. So I attended the party, and the rest is pretty much history.
Love is
there was something special about Ingrid. One New Year's, I was having a bit of car trouble. She came to Tuscaloosa to pick me up, drove me to my church for a watch night service, pretty much just dropped me out. That really stood out in my mind, because I didn't think that anyone would do something like that for someone they'd only known for a short period of time.
So one Sunday after church, Eugene asked me if I wanted to go out to eat, and I told him we could go to my parents' house since my mom was fixing dinner. He said that was fine. He had to attend to some business first, and then we'd meet up at my house. So I went shopping, and by the time I made it to my house, Eugene was pulling up, and I was excited because I was hungry. And he got in the car. He was acting a little strange, but I didn't know why at that time. So I told him I would call my mom on my way up to her house to see, let her know we were on the way and see what she was cooking. When I called her, she was acting a little strange. She said, "Have you seen Eugene?" I'm saying, "Yeah, he's with me. We're on our way." Now, mind you, my mom lives up the street, so it didn't take us very long to get there. On the way there, Eugene said, "When we get there, I'm going to open your door to let you out." I'm thinking, okay, whatever. So when I parked the car, he came around, opened my door, and he said, "Before we go in, I just want to let you know how much I love you, how much I care about you." And I'm thinking, okay, whatever, I'm ready to eat. But he got down on one knee and asked me to be his wife, and I was shocked and speechless. I think I said, "Right now, really?" And he said, "I'm waiting on an answer." And I said, "Of course." And I gave him a hug. There was no crying, no tears, just excitement and happiness.
So I decided to ask Ingrid to marry me. The first step was to actually purchase a ring. My mother was really helpful in helping me to find a ring that we both felt would reflect the type of marriage I wanted to have. After buying the ring, I was left to kind of wonder how I was going to ask her parents about marrying her. And one Sunday afternoon, we got out of church early, so I decided that would be the day I asked. I called her mother and father and asked if I could come over and speak with them. They said, "Sure, of course." So I came over and I immediately, asked them where Mr. Johnson was. Miss Johnson told me, so I went to talk to him, and I explained to him my intentions and what the purpose of me talking with him was. And he was happy. He accepted. He called his Miss Johnson's wife down, and we all talked and discussed the date and whatnot, and everything went on well from there. After that, I was left with the task of actually proposing to him. Before I left, her mother was pretty glad of the news, and she was pretty anxious to spread the news. So I knew that I had to propose to Ingrid quickly after that. So I immediately went back to her house because we were supposed to be meeting up to go to dinner. Judging from the fact that I knew her mother was kind of anxious to spread the news, I figured that I shouldn't go ahead with the plan I had, and that I should go ahead and propose to her immediately, because we were kind of headed to her mother's house. I didn't want her to get there and I not had already proposed. So we got in the car and started off toward her parents' house, and I'm steady thinking, how am I going to propose to her before we get there? So on the way, I asked if I could come around and open her door, and she reluctantly said yes. I guess she felt as though I was acting kind of strange, which I admittedly was. But I came around and I actually proposed. And the thing that I remember most about the proposal is that she never answered at first. I had to kind of coerce the answer from her, but she said yes, and I guess that was just the start of our journey together.
As we begin this new journey together, I look forward to growing in Christ with Eugene, us beginning a family together, us just having a partnership and growing old together, getting to know each other more.